Well, I'm just in the process of investigating a bit of a rough running issue with the Volvo, and I think I'm going to have to remove an injector. Basically, if we have a look at all the five injectors, you can see they're all pretty dry in there, with the exception of one. It's a wet black gunge there. Basically, the symptoms are the car runs generally okay when it's warmed up, but when it's cold we get, we'll say, a partial misfire. It's not a full-on cylinder deal. Obviously, with this being an end injector, I've used a bit of blue tack here. That's when I had to remove one a while ago. I built a little tiny dam out of some blue tack just to hold the carburetor cleaner in place while I left it to soak. So we'll squirt a little in that and come back to it tomorrow. Try and squirt it slowly so I waste less. I want to fill that void up. I want a good head of it really, so I can see if it's gone down or not. Hopefully it will go down tomorrow. If not, I do have a few things to try. I will discuss them anyway in case you need these techniques. It would be really nice if I don't have to try them. So we've got a good head of the fluid there. I just make a mental note of where the fluid level is. So we're just slightly below the clamp there. So that should get where it's needed. I'll just remove a few of the bigger deposits. Well, it's now been in the region of 24 hours. And I'm pleased to report that the carburetor cleaner has dropped down, which is good news because it's actually dropping down into the injector. So let's think of it like an inverted cone where the injector sits. So we've now got carburetor cleaner in that. So the next thing to do is see if we can rotate this. So I'll just apply a little penetrating spray to either bolt on the clamp and let that work its magic. So one bolt's been a little stubborn. These are actually 8mm, so I'm being really careful. Just free enough there nicely. Really careful not to apply too much force because they will actually round. And you can see we've got a six-sided socket, so there's less places for it to go. It's just this one, which I don't want anything to happen to. So I'm just going to use a little technique and in the hope that it works. I'll demonstrate it. Have to be very careful using it and accurate. What I want to do is to apply some turning force and tension on this ratchet, and then we'll use a hammer and just gently send some shock waves down in the hope that that works the penetrating fluid in. Yeah, you hear that crack, it just went. So we'll remove the bolts for now. Oh, that doesn't feel very good at all. I'm just going to work some penetrating fluid back and forth into that. I don't want to damage the threads. So it's quite literally three steps forward, two steps back. And you can feel it's getting easier, so great stuff. We'll get the ratchet on this to speed it up. So with both bolts removed, you can see the clamp is quite loose, which is exactly what we want. We don't want that holding anything in. I think I can actually just see a lump there. Right, so we're going to remove this nut from the injector and we'll see if it'll turn. If not, I've got a few ideas in mind. Came off nicely. So it's not moving by hand. Oh, it is, actually. Well, that was easier than I thought. That was the carburetor cleaner working. So we've got a turning action, so then we should be able to wiggle the injector upwards. And it should be lovely and wet with all the cleaner which we've got attached. Just disconnect the power lead and the leak off valve. I'll just get the camera down here so you can see how shiny it is with all the carburetor fluid. And it's gone right down to the tip, which is excellent news. Even though it's pretty dirty, it does need a clean up. That's brilliant. The main thing is I've got this out. I will go into a bit more detail on the other methods I haven't needed to use in this case, all thanks to the carburetor cleaner. I've been very lucky. Well, I gave this injector a clean up and I've checked it all the way around. I did actually have one I removed, and there was a huge crack there, and that was the one which was an absolute swine to remove. Basically, I did the carburetor treatment for around a fortnight, every use of the car, fresh squirt. I think I used a full aerosol of carburetor cleaner. The good news is the injector seal has came out with the injector, even though it's currently stuck on, but I think a pair of pliers may liberate that. The other methods, right, basically you can slacken the bolts a full turn and drive the car as normal. That's what I ended up doing with the one which was horrible really to remove. It was just, if you can just imagine it being a big black gungy mess. And the other technique is use a slide hammer. Now, I didn't actually use the proper injector slide hammer. I'll just show you it. So what I basically did, I had the engine warm. They are actually easier to remove warm. And I just hooked the slide hammer around there and just gave it a few up and down taps, just to assist with the removal. And that injector did eventually come out, but it was the most testing one I have ever done, and I doubt I'll get another one to recreate on video like that. So let's get on with the cleanup. We've got this injector tip to clean up, and there is a bit of gunge there, so basically this injector seal is gunged on. So we'll just give it a squirt of the old carburetor cleaner and we'll give it a little bit of a bath. See, I've got the surplus being collected in the cap. I have a purpose for that in mind, which we'll get to in due course. And I've got a toothbrush, an old toothbrush I've reserved for this purpose. I don't want to use anything metallic on these injectors. So when in the tip there are a few holes, and that's where the diesel will be squirting out of. So you don't want to use anything metallic whatsoever. So I've got a pair of swan necks, and avoiding touching the very tip, I just want to grab into the injector seal, give it a little turn there, and we'll continue cleaning that up. There is actually a way of removing the injector seal if it's still down there. So if your injector seal didn't come out with the injector, what you're going to need is a screwdriver, and probably one a little longer than this, and you're going to need it so the injector seal locks onto the taper, like so. So you put that down there, find it, and hopefully retrieve it with a little push, just to lock it in like so. So we'll have a bit of a clean up round here, and then we'll get to fitting the injector. So I'll just go gently fishing down the injector seat and just give the screwdriver a wipe with a rag every time it surfaces. I'm just using it very gently, we're not scratching it or anything. Very light pressure. So now we've got the thick out of there, what we want to do is make a tool. So we've got a cloth there, and we'll just cover it with the, I'll put it around the screwdriver. And this is our cleaning tool. It's quite a lengthy screwdriver, this. And then we'll spray that with the carburetor cleaner. Particularly at the tip, that's the area we want to clean. We want a nice clean seat for our newly cleaned injector to rest on. I'll just turn that round, do that sufficient times till we're happy. So I've spent quite a bit of time in there getting it as clean as possible. What we need is a nice clean seat to rest our new injector seal on. We've also applied the same principles to the injector. This bit here has been exceptionally well cleaned. And the tip, we can actually see the four injector holes. So we'll now insert the injector. I've got some replacement seals. I thought I'd buy a household name, good brand hopefully, because I have been in here before and I'm hoping not to have to do this again. Hopefully in this video I'll identify possibly why it didn't work out, but it has lasted in excess of 3 years, so I can't really complain. The injector seal just slides quite nicely over. To give it a bit of a wiggle. In baby steps anyway. Before we actually fit it, I've just thought of something here. This is the injector pre-filter, so we'll remove that and give it a clean. So we've got some carburetor cleaner again, and the cap, and this is the injector filter, and you can see it's basically a trap. There are three holes in this, either side, so any dirt or anything, just it has to make it through that hole and that hole, and with the angle of it, it's more likely to be trapped in there. I have actually cleaned all of them on this car, so we'll just see what condition this is in. And a bit of dirt in it, I think. Hard to see. Yeah, we'll give it a little bath. So it is dirty, so there could be some merit in cleaning the lot. Yeah, that looks dirty to me. So we have got some dirt out of it, great. Well, we'll refit everything now. So I'll just gently assemble this finger tight, and I'll just rotate it slightly, and it's looking good. I think we'll put a bit of copperese on the bolts, just in case. And that is indeed more than enough. I'll just tighten these up to spec using a torque wrench. Bit of a debate for this engine, 13 or 28 newton meters. I'll go to 13 and see how it feels. I think 13's gonna do it. Just torque them up evenly. Yeah, 13 is ample in my opinion. And that one's gone. And that one's gone. Now, what I like to do, and it seems a backward step this, is slacken them off and then retorque. So we've got everything almost reconnected. Now what I'm going to do is just drop a bit of carb cleaner in the injector, just so as the diesel pushes it through. That job finished. You may wonder why I put a bit of Tippex on it earlier in the video. That was just in case I accidentally unscrewed the injector. Many thanks for watching, and why not subscribe to learn of more repair possibilities.